the next another topic, nutrition in human beings. Nutrition in human beings. It is also known as the digestive system of human beings. First of all, digestion. What is digestion? The process of breaking down complex substances to simple substances with the help of enzymes. It absorbs into the body. This process is called digestion. Here once again the definition of digestion. The process of breakdown complex substances into simple substances with the help of enzymes and absorbs into the body. This process is called digestion. Here, human digestive system is very complex. Human digestive system is very complex nature. Here the different parts involving the performing and different functions. Performing the different functions by using various digestive juice and enzymes. Here the children, let us observe the figure. Digestive system. Let us observe the figure digestive system. Here see children, first of all, digestive parts is first of all mouth, buccal cavity, pharynx, esophagus, stomach, small intestine and large intestine, rectum, anus. These are the sequential parts of our digestive parts. First of all, mouth. Here see the children, this is the digestive system of human beings. First of all, mouth. The natural opening through which food passes into the body. Food enters into the mouth. Next, buccal cavity. This is a next part, buccal cavity. Here the mouth has completed. Next part, buccal cavity. Here see children, this is the buccal cavity. This is the oral cavity also. Buccal cavity or oral cavity. Here the buccal cavity, food is cut and crushed by our teeth. Food is cut and crushed by our teeth in the mouth and mixed with saliva. To make wet and slippery. It is called as mastication. Here the saliva is secreted by three salivary glands. Here see children, three salivary glands. Two pairs are located in the lower jaw and below the tongue. Next one pair is located in the palate. See children, palate. Next, saliva mainly contains amylase enzyme. The function of the amylase enzyme, complex carbohydrates are converted into simple ones. Next, the tongue. The tongue helps mixing the food and pushing it into the next part. The lower jaw is also help in this process. Next part, pharynx. See children, here this is the pharynx. Pharynx, it is a masticated food pushing into the next part. Pushing into the next part, esophagus. Next part, esophagus. The soft food, esophagus. See children, this is a, it is a muscular tube that is approximately 25 centimeters long. Esophagus is approximately 25 centimeters long. It connects the throat and stomach. Esophagus connects the throat and stomach and transport food by using muscle contractions. And next, the soft food mixed. Here the children, the soft food mixed with the saliva passes through the esophagus by wave-like motion, by wave-like movement. That is called as peristaltic movement. That is called as peristaltic movement. Here the food is next to pass through the, through this. Next part, stomach. Here see children, this is a stomach. This is a stomach. Here before the stomach, food is in the form of a soft slimy substance. Food is in the form of a soft slimy substance where some proteins and carbohydrates have already been broken down is called as chyme. Here very very important half mark question children, what is chyme? Once again repeat, food in the form of a soft slimy substance where some proteins and carbohydrates have already been broken down is called as chyme. The food material processes from the stomach to the small intestine. Here the small intestine, next part. Before the small intestine, here stomach, proteins are converted into the smaller molecules. Here the acting enzyme pepsin. Proteins converted into the smaller ones with the help of pepsin and trypsin. See children, here in the stomach, churned with gastric juice and HCl are secreted in this part. Here the food is semi-solid condition. The digestion of food goes on. Most proteins are broken down. Into smaller ones with the help of pepsin and trypsin enzymes. Here the children, the food in the form of a soft slimy substance whereas some proteins and carbohydrates have already been broken down is called as chyme. Now the food material passes from the stomach to the smaller intestine. Next part, smaller intestine. See children, this is the small intestine. Here the ring-like muscles are present. That is called as pyloric muscles. The function of the pyloric muscles, it is regulating the opening of the passage. It is regulating the opening of the passage such that only small quantities of food material may be passed in the small intestine at a time. Okay, next, smaller intestine. Small intestine, it is the small intestine is the longest part of our alimentary canal. Nearly 7.5 meters. It is the 7.5 meters. It is the nearly 7.5 meters. It is the site of further digestion. Proteins, digestion of carbohydrates, proteins and fats. Here in the it receives the secretion of liver. Secretion of liver and pancreas. For this purpose, these juice render the internal condition of the intestine gradually basic or alkaline. Next, emulsification. Fats are digested by converting them into small globules like forms by the help of the bile juice. Bile juice secreted from liver. Bile juice containing no enzymes. Bile juice secreted from liver. This process is called emulsification. Next, success. This process called emulsification. Next, sucks. Sucks means Telugulo chushakalu, children. Here, the wall of the small intestine secretes intestinal juice. Called sucks. Here the sucks entrichias which carry this process further, that is small molecules of proteins and fats are broken down to smaller molecules. It is the function of sucks. Next, villi. See, children, small intestine having intestinal walls. Intestinal walls has a number of finger-like projections. Called villi. The main function of villi, absorption of nutrients. Here, what is the absorption? Transport of the products of digestion from the intestine into blood through the wall of intestine is called as absorption. Here, see, children, carbohydrates digestion started in the mouth and did not occur in the stomach. Here, now as the medium gradually changes to an as the medium gradually changes to an alkaline. One and the enzymes become active for carbohydrates. Active for carbohydrates. Next, products of digestion are absorbed first into the villi. Products of digestion are absorbed first into the villi. Thus, after this is the small intestine. Here, see children, small intestine is again divided into two parts. One jejunum, second one ileum. The one jejunum and second one ileum. Here the this is the small intestine. Next part the large intestine. Thus after maximum absorption of food, in the small intestine, the rest passes into the large intestine. Here the most of water is present in the large intestine material. See children, this is the large intestine. This unwanted material expelled. Undigested material are expelled through the anus. Here, large intestine having mainly unwanted material or undigested food materials are stored in the large intestine. Next, anus, which is the last part of the digestive alimentary canal. Here see children, defecation. What is defecation? What is the meaning of defecation? Here, unwanted or undigested food materials from the body through the anus. Is called defecation. This is the digestive system of human beings. Here, what are the major steps in this digestive system? See children, the major steps of digestion: ingestion, taking of food, into the body. Next, digestion. Digestion and breaking complex substances into simple. Tarvata, absorption. Third one, absorption. Digested food through the walls of the assimilation of alimentary tract. Next, the last one, defecation. The process of unwanted material from our body through the anus. This is called defecation. These four major steps involved in the digestion process. Next, vomiting. The peristaltic movement of the peristaltic movement of the stomach and esophagus reverse their normal function. Reverse their normal direction, and the food is expelled. Is known as vomiting. Here once again repeat children, vomiting. The peristaltic movement, already I explained in the buccal cavity, what is peristaltic movement? Now, the peristaltic movement of the stomach and esophagus, stomach and esophagus reverse their normal direction, and the food is expelled through the mouth. This is called as vomiting. Causes of vomiting. Here, overeating, especially when the food contains heavy proteins and heavy fats. Vomiting also occur when we eat something over indigestion. These are the causes for vomiting. Next, health aspects of the alimentary canal. What is the health aspects? Here, see children, having simple, well-balanced diet. And eating them in a leisurely manner. Truly masticating the food. Avoid taking violent exercise soon after eating food. Next, drinking plenty of water in a day and having regularly bowel movements. Having plenty of water. These are the health aspects of alimentary canal. This is the our digestion. Once again, summarize the children. Now, what is digestion? The process of breaking down complex substances into simple substances with the help of enzymes and absorbs into the body. This process is called digestion. Here, human digestive system is a very complex. Here, the involving various parts and various digestive enzymes and digestive juices. Here, the involving digestive parts, mouth, buccal cavity, pharynx, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, rectum, anus. These are the human digestive system. Okay children, next continue the topic digestive enzymes. Studying the enzymes chart in your textbook, page number 15, see children. Here, enzyme chart. First, enzymes secreted into digestive juice acts on products. See children, tylin enzyme secreted by salivary glands. Secreted into buccal cavity. Digestive juice saliva acts on carbohydrates converted into maltose. Next, pepsin. It is secreted by gastric glands. It is secreted into stomach. It is digestive juice, gastric juice. It is act on proteins. Proteins converted into peptones. Next, bile. Third one, bile. It has no enzymes, children. This is a special. It has no enzymes. It is secreted by liver. It is secreted into duodenum. Already we know that part, duodenum. The small intestine having two parts. That is one, duodenum and ileum. Here the duodenum. Now, bile juice. Next, digestive juice is present in the bile juice. Here, acts on fats. Boil juice, eggs and fats. Here, emulsification, breaking down of large fat molecules into small globules. Next one, amylase. Amylase, it is secreted by pancreas. It is secreted into duodenum. It is a digestive juice, pancreatic juice. It is acts on carbohydrates. It is carbohydrates converted into maltose. Next, trypsin. Trypsin secreted by pancreas, secreted into duodenum. Digestive juice, pancreatic juice. It is act on proteins, converted into peptones. Next, lipase. Lipase secreted by pancreas. It is secreted into duodenum. It is digestive juice, pancreatic juice. It is act on fats. It is fats converted into fatty acids and glycerols. Next, peptidase. Peptidase is secreted by intestinal gland. Secreted into small intestine. It is digestive juice, intestinal juice. Here, intestinal juice act on peptidase. Peptidase converted into amino acids. These amino acids are Next, sucrase. It is secreted by intestinal gland. Secreted into small intestine. Digestive juice, intestinal juice. Next, it is act on sucrose. Sucrose converted into glucose. This is the digestive enzyme chart. This is a very important, children. Here the questions are will ask in your exam point of view. Here given the table and asking the questions. Okay, children. Digestive enzymes table no simple ga gurtu pettukodaniki enzymes product converted product simple ga gurtu pettukodaniki ఒకసారి చూద్దాము. కార్బోహైడ్రేట్స్ కన్వర్టెడ్ ఇంటూ మాల్టోస్. యాక్ట్ ఆన్ ఎంజైమ్ టైలిన్. ప్రోటీన్స్ కన్వర్టెడ్ ఇంటూ పెప్టోన్స్ విత్ ద హెల్ప్ ఆఫ్ పెప్సిన్ ఎంజైమ్. ఫ్యాట్స్ కన్వర్టెడ్ ఇంటూ స్మాల్ గ్లోబ్యూల్స్ విత్ ద హెల్ప్ ఆఫ్ బైల్. బైల్ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ నో ఎంజైమ్స్. This is secreted by liver. Secreted into pancreas. Next, carbohydrates converted into maltose with the help of amylase enzyme. Next, proteins. Proteins converted into peptones with the help of trypsin enzyme. Fats. Fats converted into fatty acids and glycerols with the help of lipase. Peptase converted into amino acids with the help of peptidase enzyme. Next, sucrose. Sucrose converted into glucose with the help of sucrase enzyme. This is the digestive enzyme table. It is very, very important for your exam point of view. Okay, children, the next topic, malnutrition. Diseases due to malnutrition. Here, what is the malnutrition? Eating of food that does not have one or more than one nutrients. One or more than one nutrients in required amount is known as malnutrition. Here the causes of malnutrition. Causes of malnutrition: poor health and lack of awareness of nutritional habits. Next, socio-economic factors. Socio-economic factors. These are the causes of malnutrition. Next, here types of malnutrition. In our syllabus, three types of malnutrition is there. One is a calorie malnutrition, obesity. Protein malnutrition, kwashiorkor. Protein calorie malnutrition, marasmus. We will discuss about, first of all, calorie malnutrition, obesity. Here the children, this is due to overeating and excess of caloric intake. Excess of caloric intake. It is a big health hazard in this period. Next, obesity children, when grow, they will be target of many diseases like diabetes, cardiovascular, renal, gallbladder problems, etc. Next, here junk foods and other food habits which leads to obesity. This is the symptoms of calorie malnutrition, obesity. Next, protein malnutrition, kwashiorkor. Kwashiorkor is also one of the protein malnutrition. Protein malnutrition. Here the symptoms of kwashiorkor: body parts become swollen. Body parts become swollen due to accumulation of water in the intracellular space. Due to accumulation of water in the intracellular space. Next, very poor muscle development, swollen lips, fluffy face, difficult to eat, and diarrhea and dry skin. These are the symptoms of kwashiorkor. Next one, the last one children, protein calorie malnutrition. This is the protein calorie malnutrition. This is the last malnutrition. Generally, this disease occurs. Generally, this disease occurs repeated childbirth. This is repeated childbirth. The symptoms of marasmus: lean and weak, and swelling in joints of limbs. Swelling in joints of limbs. Less developed muscles and dry skin, diarrhea. These are the malnutrition symptoms. These are the malnutrition symptoms. Once again repeat the children. Now in this session, see children, malnutrition, the kwashiorkor symptoms: body parts become swollen and due to accumulation of water in the intracellular spaces. See children, this one. And very poor muscle development, swollen legs, fluffy face, muscle development, difficult to eat, diarrhea and dry skin. These are the symptoms of kwashiorkor. See children like this. Next, marasmus. Generally, this disease occurs when there is immediate second pregnancy. Here see children, this picture marasmus indicates marasmus. Lean and weak body, swelling in joints of limbs, and less developed muscle system, dry skin and diarrhea. Next, calorie malnutrition, obesity. See children, this picture. Obesity. This is due to overeating and excess of intake of over calories. It is a big health hazard. Obese children, when grow up, they will be target of many diseases like diabetes, cardiovascular and renal gallbladder problems and etc. Next, junk foods and other food habits which leads to obesity. Okay, thank you children. Session, we have to learn what is heterotrophic, the modes of heterotrophics, saprophytes and parasitic plants, and nutrition in amoeba, and nutrition in human beings, and also enzyme short, digestive enzyme short, and diseases due to malnutrition. Those are discussed in this session. Here children, home assessment. I am giving home assessment. If you have to draw the diagram of our digestive system and write down the digestive enzymes. See children,